for everything. So, the next speaker, please. I can't pronounce it. Yes, this is our friend from India, so you can better than me pronounce your names.
We'll take our names.
But you have to pronounce the names.
Yeah.
I will not come. I will go away.
I will try after this session. We can meet and you can teach me. I don't understand nothing in Indian.
So, non-discrimination, the ancient reference in Indian philosophy is Vasudeva Kutumbakam, which means the whole world is one family. So, all my relatives here, namaste. My name is Sunit and I'm going to tell you about Tanakh School, and we are going to show some videos rather than speak, we'll speak less and show more. One main problem which we face is we do not pay attention to what unites us. It's very obviously not comes out when, you know, we add planet to our addresses. We don't. And this obviously not becomes a part of our habit with regard to everything else. And we keep ignoring what unites us, what's common among us. That's the beginning of discrimination. Our consciousness has to be developed in a way that we, when we look at someone, we don't look at some differences between the two people, we look at the commonalities. If we start doing that, this will clear a lot of discrimination, you know, the thoughts which normally people get. The concept of planets will evolve via the same philosophy, that what's common, planet is all common to all of us. So that's why the name Planet School, that's why the solution is called Planet School. Now the aim of Planet School is that to remove all all the problems which children face with respect to discrimination. Permanently remove them, because we are talking about problems, we are not actually talking about disease, we are talking about symptoms more. For example, Roma children, that's a symptom, etc. They're all symptoms. But disease, this is not the disease, this is something else. To focus on disease, you need tools. You need proper diagnostic and you need work-based effort to tackle them. Planet School is basically a software platform including on-ground activities which possibly can give it a try. It will be successful or not, we don't know, but this is going to be the try. We have a manifesto in which we have documented what our intentions are going to be, on what lines we are going to implement, and it's editable for all, even you can come and participate in it. One of the portions of the manifesto was this, in which we are going to empower UNICEF to practically implement the CRC, UNCRC. We are not here for theory, we are all practitioners. So we believe, unless we do something on the ground, it's of no use. Events should be replaced by continuous process. So right now what's happening is, we are starting a pilot in 2015. The process already started. This pilot will be in India. And these are pilot numbers, these are not numbers for the entire project. So these pilot numbers will include 30,000 schools. It will include 4 million children. It will include 2.5 million youth and the top NGOs of India. This is pilot numbers. The actual implementation will include everyone in this world. For this pilot, we've got Vidya Bharati, which is the largest school network in the world. The 30,000 schools belong to Vidya Bharati. And these schools are not same. These 30,000 schools are not same. Some of them are in remote mountain areas, some of them are in desert, some of them are in such places where there are no resources. Children, they are getting education because these people took pay to open a school there. Some of these schools are the best and the most expensive schools of India. So even if you are doing this pilot for these 30,000 schools, it doesn't mean that I am not solving this, you know, problem for one kind of schools. I am actually solving the problem for all kinds of schools within a single chain. So the same thing can be magnified and we'll have the similar situation around the world. 4 million children are among number of children which are studying in these schools. And we have a organization called Akhil Bharati Vidyarthi Parishad, ABBP, which has, is the biggest youth organization of the world, which has 2.5 million youth, college-going students who are going to volunteer and make sure this gets implemented on the ground. Among the NGO, we have Prayas. I'll just speak about it. I have with me, before inviting Mr. Kant, I'll just tell briefly about him. He has been the former DGP of multiple states in India, a top cop, and he has been awarded highest gallantry award, President Award for his police career. His NGO Prayas has been working since last 26 years in India, and it has physically helped over 1.5 million children. That's work of one NGO, and we are talking about groundwork, we're not talking about research and everything, we are talking about real work. And the output has been amazing. Even the Nobel laureate, Mr. Kailash Satyarthi, was supposed to be here with us. He couldn't because he has to receive his Nobel Prize in Moscow after a few days. He has left a message along with Amod sir, which I'll be playing afterwards. Even his organization, which is called Bachpan Bachao Andolan, which claims, which has saved 80,000 children, rescued them from child labor and other evils, they use Prayas as a collaborator. Prayas has been the main partner of Bachpan Bachao Andolan as well. And they have been long friends, Mr. Amod Kand and Kailash Satyarthi. And any question for me? Otherwise, I'll just introduce Mr. Kant and play the video which has been sent by Mr. Kailash Satyarthi. Alright, I'll just play out the video from the Nobel laureate and then I'll invite you.
First of all,
you'll recognize him for sure. He is the this year's Nobel laureate, Mr. Kailash Satyarthi, receiving Nobel Prize on 10th of this month. He was with us 2-3 days back. We worked together for 25 years. So in fact, he said that he would like to send a small message. He's sending here for this conference.
Unfortunate that I cannot attend your conference. And I am so happy that Amol Bhai is going to help. And he will definitely bring the flow of knowledge and information, including the deepest possible academic input into this conference, I'm sure. So he will bring a mix of experience, knowledge, and thoughts. I can say academic thoughts. So that's good.
Still out of school in the Indian age group of let's say 60-14 years, and all of them are being in child labor. I mean, they are not exactly child labor, but they are being in child labor because they are not going through the normal education program. Our task is to really find solutions for them, and perhaps this conference is going to help in that entire process. We wish that Mr. Kailash Satyarthi, should have been there. But because he is receiving Nobel Prize almost about the same time, so obviously he can't make it. So we are really going to best out of it, and we shall kind of wait for the future that the same group when it meets again, other groups when we meet next time, anywhere else, Kailash will be there. And we shall be together to kind of take the message and make it again.
I saw his picture in Germany. Actually, that was the photo.
I know. Friends, well, I think I don't have to talk much because there is a small documentary which will talk about the organization. See, a couple of points I want to mention. Number one, that this Planet School, the idea about which my friend was talking about, and of course the lady sitting here from Estonia, Nina, in fact, they are working together on that subject, that how to combine the global children. And not only that, the children from variety of situations, the children whose rights are being deprived day in, day out, particularly the one half of humanity, those kind of children who happen to be in extremely deprived conditions, globally, all over. What happens in India, we would like to show you in a video, which is of course a very serious issue, and Prayas is working there. The whole idea is that we believe that rights and needs of children are synonymous. When you talk about the rights of the elder people, you are really talking about the justiciability of right. You have to go to the court of law and to say that this is my right, I claim it, I must get it. Whereas for children, there is nothing such right. These rights are something, you know, which is written in the United Nations Convention Rights of Child, which are there in the law books. But children as a class, because they are so young, they are so vulnerable, they are so helpless, they are not able to claim their rights. Whether they are Roma children, about whom we heard so much, or they happen to children from any part of humanity. The children are not expected to get their rights themselves. The children are supposed to be helped by others. It's for us, the world of the adults, the elder world, which is supposed to get the children and get their rights fulfilled. That is the basic issue. Now, the children all over the world, definitely there is a need to combine them, put them together. And the whole idea, which of course,